Hey guys, what's up? My name's Natalie. Welcome back to my channel, Nat's Bookshelf. Or if you're new here, welcome to my channel. Today I have for you another Bookmas video. And it is gonna be These Books Will Self-Destruct in 12 Months. This is a video idea that I actually got from Becca and the Books, and I will link one of her videos like this down below so you can go check it out. But I think I've seen her do like one or two of these, and I really liked the idea of it, and she kind of inspired me a little bit. So the premise of this video is that these are 12 books that I have on my physical TBR. To be honest, there's actually more than 12, but I grouped one of them together because it's a series. But these are 12 books that I have on my physical TBR that I'm just not so sure that I want to read. So I have 12 months to read them till next December. And if I have not, then I have to unhaul them. And as a book hoarder, this is an amazing idea. So without further ado, I'm just gonna jump into these. So the first book that I have on this list, I don't know much about, I know a tad bit, but that is The Rose Code by Kate Quinn. This is a World War II spy novel, and I'm just not sure that that's something that I'm intrigued by anymore, and I'm pretty sure I got this at like Goodwill or something. So I'm just not sure that this is something that I want to pick up anymore, so I put this on my list. Next up on this list is a book that I actually got off of Etsy for one of those blind date with a book things. I received it and it could be good, but I don't know. We'll see. If you've happened to read this and know what it is and it is good, let me know. But that is going to be Shadowmancer by G.P. Taylor. Yeah, I don't know much about this. I know that there's like a sorcerer that's trying to be all powerful and a group of friends trying to stop him. So, votes on what I should do about this. It's pretty short, so I could probably get it done quickly. I do would like to see if it's in a series, because if it is, I'm probably just not interested in starting it. I have so many series on my physical TBR that I need to get through that I'm just not sure I want to do this anymore. And the next book, or should I say books, on this list is in a series. And I have actually read the first one. I have to say, I watched this TV show before I read these books. And I think I prefer the TV show, so I'm just not sure that I'm going to continue in this series. But yeah, we'll just go ahead and get into it. That is the Sookie Stackhouse series. Now, I don't think these are necessarily in order. This is the second one, but I'm not sure which ones these are. But I just bought them as I would see them. And yeah, now I'm just not so sure that I even want to read them. So yeah, I guess if I don't read them in the next year, they're gonna get unhauled. So, the next book on this list, I don't know much about, and I'm just, I don't know. I could still end up reading this. I might not. I might end up getting rid of it. But that is The One and Only by Emily Griffin. I believe this is like women's fiction, possibly a love story. I know it follows a 33-year-old, so, I mean, that's kind of cool. Always down to read from somebody in my age group. I just don't know. I'm not pulled towards this book anymore, and I really need to get into the habit of unhauling because I have over 700 unread books on my shelf. Like, it's truly ridiculous. So, yeah, this is one of those. The next book up on this list I actually bought at the Dollar Tree, and it is a YA love story, which I'm just not so sure is my thing anymore as I'm a grown-ass adult. And that is Permanent Record by Mary H.K. Choi. I have heard about this book and I was surprised to see it at the Dollar Tree, which is why I ended up picking it up because, hello, it was a dollar. And I'm just not so sure that I'm interested in it anymore. The next book up on this list is by a pretty well-known author, and I'm just not so sure that it's my thing. It's a detective mystery thing, and I just don't know if those are my thing yet. So, and that is going to be Dragon Tears by Dean Koontz. I believe this is by about a cop who has to kill somebody on the job, and then some creepy homeless guy tells him he's gonna die soon, and so it may be a bit paranormal. I picked it up because I've heard a lot about Dean Koontz. And of course, the super shiny blue cover, which I love, but I'm just not sure that this is something I want to read. So if I get to it next year, liking it or not, that's great. But if I don't, I'm gonna get rid of it. The next book up on this list is a nonfiction and also by a pretty popular author. And that is going to be Girl, Stop Apologizing by Rachel Hollis. I've read so many self-help stuff, and I'm just not sure that I need this. So, why not just get rid of it and let somebody else that needs it have it? So, I may end up just reading it. Like, it is pretty short, but I may not. Let's be honest. The next book up on this list is another historical fiction, and that is going to be The Age of Light by Whitney Strieber, I think is how you say that. This takes place in 1920s and is about a Vogue model turned photographer. I mean, it could be cool if you've read this and you did like it, let me know down below because this could be one that I'm into. I'm just not sure on the like the straight historical fiction. This is still a possibility, guys. The next book is also from a pretty well-known and popular author, and that is going to be Sublime by Christina Loren. Now, I think this is actually one of her lesser known novels, but I'm pretty sure it's like a paranormal romance, and I'm just not sure that I'm into that. I don't know how I feel about human and ghost love. It's weird. So, this book definitely made that list. The next book I have on this list is by another really popular, well-known author, guys. It's becoming a thing in this video. But that is going to be The Innocent Man by John Grisham. I don't know much about this. I know it is portrayed as a legal thriller, which could very much be up my alley. And maybe I should hold on to this and read it because I'm all about true crime, and this seems like something I could get into. But at the same time, it is one of the books that I'm less attached to on my shelves, which is how I got all these because I'm pretty attached to my books and I don't want to unhaul, but I really need to unhaul. So if I don't read this in the next year, it's gonna get unhauled. I kind of want to read it. Let me know. Any John Grisham fans watching this? This next book is a book that I bought because I had seen it on somebody else's TBR that I watch, and I think it was Jacqueline. I will link her channel down below. But then she had started it and said it's not really her thing, and after further investigation, I don't think it's my thing either. It's got to do with a polyamorous relationship, I believe. Which, you know, to each their own, and if that is something that you love, that is awesome. I think I actually have this book posted on Pango Books already, so it actually might not even get read and it might get sold before then. But yeah, I'm not interested and I don't see myself reading this, and that is The Marriage Pass by Brianna Cole. Like I said, I think this has to do with a polyamorous relationship. And from what I had heard is that this guy gets a marriage pass and he wants to use it to sleep with his wife's sister, which is just weird, guys. It's just not my cup of tea. So yeah, that is the last book on this list. Let me know, guys. Have you read any of these books? Do you like any of these books? Are they good? Are they bad? Give me the tea, okay? And I really hope you enjoyed this video. If this is something that you guys do enjoy, maybe I'll do this like once a year where I go through my shelves and pick 12 books that will self-destruct in 12 months. But yeah. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like the video. It really helps me out and gets me out there. And don't forget to subscribe, hit that little bell notification, and you'll get notified every time I upload, which is every day this December. You don't want to miss that. And I will see you guys next time. Bye. Thank you.